Hello everyone. Today we are cooking eggplant stuff. It's stuff that you put on a bread. We need about 1 kilogram. For that I put those on a scale. No, I don't use the scale. It's 1 kilo is like 1 kilo, like this. About the same. First, before we start, we need hot water. Then we slice them in little cubes. Always good to have a sharp knife when running around in Germany and in the kitchen. Not running around in the kitchen, but having a sharp knife in the kitchen is a good idea. And before you ask, yes, those are cubes. We're gonna cook them until they are all muddy and get mixed up in the end. This is why they don't have to be tiny or small, just about those, this size is enough. While we slice those eggplant cubes, we're gonna heat up some olive oil need to put those on the next chopping list. Heat up some oil and continue frying. I'm not one of those fancy TV cooks that have a bowl for everything. Just if your kitchen is clean, you can just toss everything around. It's not getting dirty. And even if I don't even have washed my hands. Okay, that's not true, I have, but you don't have to, because everything of this gets boiled and cooked and fried about hundreds of degrees. Every germ dies. You don't have to be aware of, oh no, I don't want to spread my germs all over the food. My children will eat the germs and they will get the plague. No, most of the germs, like totally most, like 99.9% die at 100 degrees Celsius, and there's at least in this dish, there's nothing that won't get heated under 100 degrees Celsius. If you haven't noticed, so until now, I'm slicing up some onions. This time it's really tiny cubes. The amount for the onions is 300 grams of a kilo, about a third of a kilo. And again, just estimate the amount, 300 grams, it's a third kilo. No need for a scale. Oh, the water is ready. The most important part, have some tea. We don't need this actually for cooking, but some like to have some whiskey while cooking. I have some tea. The onions, as you probably know by now are getting heat up in the olive oil. Once the oil is boiling hot, you can reduce the temperature. Like drastically reduce it. I got from 1 to 6 and I've started with 6 and now I'm at 1. All those biceps with measurements, 300 grams here and 250 grams there, a teaspoon of some spice. You really should not follow those and be the most exact about everything. Take some spice, for example, we're using cayenne pepper in the next steps. I've got this about half a year. The taste is now much less hot than it was on the first day. So a teaspoon of this now is not a teaspoon of it 6 months ago. So all those recipes stating exact amounts, it's just silly to follow them. Also the eggplants, the onions, everything. It's you don't know, is this onion fresh from the field? Or was it in an storage for 2 years? It's possible. And if it's 2 years laying around, this onion is not as intense as fresh from the field. We take a small one, the smallest is this one, and then we are good. Oh no, look how much she's throwing away. The child in Africa could have eaten it. As I stated before, a sharp knife is something necessary, but this doesn't mean I have one. It's like, this one is like semi-sharp. And if I'm starting to sound a bit whimpering, that's because those onions really are intense. Not quite fresh from the field, but intense. Some garlic, and people always cry about, oh no, it's so hard to peel them off. Just do this. This, and you have to lift them like this, and then if you have cut those loose ends and lifted them like I showed, that's all. It's good. Really easy. No reason to cry. About how difficult it is, because it's not. You just have to do it right. I won't cut those in tiny bits because that's so annoying. I just use a press. Did I say that's garlic? It's garlic. and it's coming in the pot to the onion. And we are not wasting anything of this. Oh, that would be no pleasant. Not enjoyable to bite on this big piece of garlic. As I said, we are not wasting anything. Oh. My kitchen is clean, I can. That's a bit fiddly here, but it's still not that annoying as slicing garlic into tiny, really, really tiny bits. Once those onions have a nice brown coat, like they have now, the eggplants come with it. Added. Speaking English, I think I've never spoken English for so long, ever. In my 9-to-5 job, I've English caller once a week, and talk about 2 minutes and that's it. And now I'm talking and talking and talking. This has to cook about 30 minutes. Again, you don't need to be exact. It can also be 35, 40, maybe 25 only. The important thing is it's ready when it's about half the size it has now, and it's all muddy. You can mash it down just with this. Now we wait and drink some tea. Due to me being an idiot, we've lost some footage. I'm just gonna repeat the steps that were recorded and are lost now without actually being able to do exactly the same. As you can see, I've added a top and I've mixed it around a bit. Every 6 to 7 minutes I came and mixed it a bit. Until it was half the size, just as I said, it took 25 minutes for me. The thing you didn't see now is how brown everything got really brown. That's the right time to add it at half the size, as I said. That's the time to get it off the oven and start mixing. Use as seasoning just some salt and cayenne pepper. I've done this. Before it starts to get really creamy, you give it a taste. If you have added too much in the first place, which you hopefully haven't, you got a problem. You could add some honey. Sucks up some spices, but it won't be this taste as intended. Start with less than you might think you would need, and as I said before, add some more when you give it a taste, when it's about 90% done. At this stage, the 90%, you should hit the spice amount you really want to eat. And then you're gonna mix the last 10% until it's a really soft and hardly fluid cream. Now we have it a really soft cream. That's the point where we add some cream fraiche. Don't add sour cream because it's sour. Ooh, have salt. Add cream fraiche because it's much more sweet and we want some sweet taste added. I take about this amount. You can take less because, oh no, my weight, I don't have to gain more kilograms just by this silly recipe. But don't add more, just this or less. That's it. Now fill it in some fancy bowl, which I don't own. And put it on some bread. At least I have a fancy knife with flowers and shit. Generously. And the best thing to put on this slice of bread with this tasty, tasty eggplant cream. I'm gonna make it more beautiful than it deserves to be. We add Sprotten. I don't know if there's an English word for something like this. Maybe the Oxford guys that decide which word will be added and which won't say, we don't want to have something this disgusting in our speech, in our language. This is why we won't translate it and just call it Sprotten, as the Germans do. And put them on there. Yes, you eat them with head and tail, everything. And that's it. Remember, if you don't like it, there's something wrong with you.
And there you go. Sprottenbrett with eggplant cream.